Welcome back to Luke Lawson Plays. Today we're diving into a little Battleborn. In case you didn't hear, this game has recently received the beautiful title of the newest and, my personal opinion, greatest free to try? I know it's a weird title. It's not something that you hear a lot of. It's not necessarily free to play, but it's also not a trial. Trial leads you to believe in the gaming industry that you're going to be doing something for a limited amount of time, and this does not have an end date. It is something that the developers have decided to open up to the general public so that you can try the game or some of it. I have a lot of love for this game. What you're seeing is the footage from the very first, the historic, the monumental first upload I ever did to YouTube. And at the point in which I began my YouTube career, I was neck deep in the Battleborn universe. It released on May 3rd in 2016, and the game itself was met with pretty good reviews, and it was fun, and people liked it. It was unique. It was the first time that the world had seen a first-person shooter in the MOBA universe. There were a lot of MOBAs that were available. There were a lot of things that you could do and see in other games that were similar to this, with tower defense and having the ability to unlock different gear sets and progress each individual round personally. But this game did something very, very neat. They also did something kind of foolish and released just a few weeks before, what's the name of that game that some of you have heard of? Overwatch? What were they thinking? So what you're seeing here in the character selection screen is going to give you just a taste of the characters that are available to you. But in the free trial, they're going to do a rotation. Instead of having all of them unlocked every time you log in, unless you own or purchase the game, you will have a rotation of 6 individual characters available to you on a weekly basis, and those will rotate week to week based on the rotation. So as the rotation progresses, you'll be able to try additional characters and test out different playstyles, different abilities, different supers and specials. Now, what you will want to keep in mind is that as you play, you'll see here, you'll be able to develop different loadouts for your characters. You'll unlock gear. Gear will come from different drops. And as opposed to, let's say, Overwatch, which is compared to often, your end of round rewards, and as you level, your rewards are loot boxes. So, okay, that's similar. But as opposed to just getting skins or taunts or sprays, you're actually going to get gear drops similar to the Borderlands franchise that will affect stats. Those pieces of gear will allow you to equip a loadout of 3 individual pieces that you take into each round with you. What you see here is you start each match with a few, I guess you could call them skill points, probably for the lack of a better term. Those skill points are in your helix tree, which is the skill tree. It's a fancy name for the skill tree. Your skill tree will continue to unlock as you play the matches. Now, let's say that you've played a first-person shooter before, and maybe you've played multiplayer first-person shooters. Then you're very familiar with the concept of this game. You have weapons, you have specials, you have ultimates. As you go through and do your damage, you'll have a chance to either kill or be killed. But each time you do something that is somewhat useful, you will also gain XP, which will level your character individually per each round. What you're seeing here is some of the... Okay, so maybe you've played a capture match before, and you have zones A, B, and C. Well, this is MOBA-based first-person shooter, so zones A, B, and C have the ability to be defended by turrets, they have the ability to be defended by minions, they have the ability to physically shut down lanes or build up lanes based on how you spend your shards. So the shards are little golden nugget-looking things that are spread across the map. They will drop from enemies whenever you kill. They will also be able to just be picked up individually, or you can generate them through different pieces of gear. That's your currency for every map. So what you see is not just beautiful gameplay that is just set up with some incredible characters and awesome specials and great abilities. The artwork is cool. You have very fluid motions and fluid fighting mechanics, but you also have that added layer of depth that gives you the ability to not just run around aimlessly trying to get the highest KD. You have that added layer that gives you that MOBA aspect of defending a territory, growing your shard counter, getting that currency, so to speak, so that you can do the unlocks throughout the match. You have the ability to do a tremendous amount more than just a team deathmatch scenario. So let's say that you've played other first-person shooters, you're gonna see some very familiar character types. This one is a melee-based, can go invisible, has some poison damage, but you have people that just use regular weapons. You have people that are support. You have healers. You have your just straight range DPS. I mean, you've got a very wide range of, I guess you could call them common character types throughout all first-person shooter games, and in some instances, different types of MOBA aspects. But you get them all mixed into this type of environment, which if you've never played before, holy smokes, it's a beautifully built, wonderfully made first-person shooter. It just has so many extra layers. That's part of the reason why I think the game itself, as much as I loved it and many of the people that I played with, it didn't have the staying power for the community, so to speak, because it was up against games that were much easier to dive into. Some of the matches in this game could potentially last 20 minutes, whereas other more popular, widely accepted shooters, such as Overwatch, you can jump in, you have no gear to unlock, you have nothing to farm for, you have no objective other than to get the most kills or move the payload to the end of the map. This gives you a little bit more depth, but it was almost its detriment. Unless you have a desire to really put some time in, or you don't want to just jump in and jump back out, this game may not be the greatest thing. But if any of those things interest you, you could absolutely be in for a treat. It is going to give you the ability to do things in a first-person shooter that you have never, and I repeat, never seen before. It's an incredibly unique experience that takes some of the most incredible aspects of many games and has smashed them into something that's quite beautiful, actually. As you go through, if you choose, and if you like it, and if you decide that you want to move past the free trial aspect, you will open up the ability to go into, this is one of the many battle arenas, or what they call operations. So in these single player instances, there is a tremendous amount of PvE content available to you that you can do as co-op or as single player, that you can unlock gear with, you can basically continue to build new loadouts, experience new parts of the game, the lore, the story behind each of the characters, and some very, and I say again, very well-written comedy. Those are all things that are part of the full release that you won't see in the free trial itself, but they're there for you should you like it enough to want to dive in a little bit deeper. In this game, whether you choose the free trial or the full release, you will have the ability to do things with your friends for $0. Whether you have friends that you already know, play, or want to play, or if you just make friends along the way, it's an incredibly, I don't know, it's a welcoming community. There's no salt or hatred. The game itself, during its lowest points, sank into the hundreds on PC, and probably a slightly higher number on the console, but it never completely faded away. There's some very passionate people that built the game, and their passion has extended into those that play it. I hope you've enjoyed the video, I hope you learned a little bit of something, and I cannot wait to play with you. If you get a wild hankering and wanna download and jump in, absolutely let me know, and I will do anything I can to join you. I'll talk to you soon.